everybody. Welcome back to Markers and Monsters. We are almost at Halloween, and I would be remiss if I didn't get to draw this Halloween staple. Yes, it's a black cat for Black Catterday. So let's just get right into it here real quick. As you can see, I'm drawing in like the cat, and I'm keeping it mostly in silhouette and with only a couple little areas where you're going to see. And then some nice jack-o'-lanterns there behind him. Just very Halloween-y, keeping it light and very simple this time around, but that's okay. Our good friend, the black cat, doesn't need an overly complex drawing to make him look pretty great. So let's fill in the moon here, and starting to put in the markers already, which is pretty impressive. Like I said, he's mostly going to be in silhouette with a little bit of the light coming from the moon and the pumpkins, just casting a couple shadows on him here. Like I said before, black cats are a definite staple of Halloween. I mean, Halloween decorations, they basically don't make decoration packs that don't come with a black cat in somewhere. It's just been one of those things that has been always and forever. Black cats equals Halloween. And you know what? That's really cool, I think. Also, the superstition of the black, if you see a black cat or if a black cat crosses your path, at least here in the States, that's the superstition. It's bad luck if a black cat crosses your path. Now, those black cat superstitions go back for, centuries, a very long time. Used to be that depending on which way the black cat went when it was in front of you would determine your luck. Like, if a black cat is walking towards you, good luck. If it walks away from you, bad luck. And I think those are all pirate superstitions. You've also, of course, got the whole black cat as witch's familiar thing that propped up from, England in a couple hundred years ago when the witch craze was big. And I believe that kind of carried over to, Salem, Massachusetts, here in the States with the famous witch trials at the end of the 1600s. So, people were always kind of wary of black cats even then. But I like how that the noble black cat has become, a Halloween staple because of that. Like, I think that, black cats always got a bad rap, but I think it's really cool that they have this perception of them now, I guess you could say it. Because when I see a black cat, I think, Halloween or something like that. It's just giving me good vibes all over. Plus, cats are really neat animals, and they're really cool, and the black color is just really, I think, a good look for a cat. I don't know, man. If I was going to go out and buy myself a cat and it was going to be a specific color, I think I might aim for the black kind. Just, that's my personality. But black cats have appeared in fiction and movies and horror movies and stuff like that relatively frequently. You've, of course, got the Edgar Allan Poe story, The Black Cat, in which the black cat is named Pluto. And definitely has a lot to do with murder and mayhem and all kind of gothic bad things that Edgar Allan Poe writes about. A woman gets an axe to the face and then bricked up into a wall, and a cat gets his eye gouged out. It's pretty intense, man. They've tried to put that in the movie a couple times with varying successes. There was a Masters of Horror episode where Jeffrey Combs plays Edgar Allan Poe, and he has his black cat running around. It's a little bit of a different take on the story, but, still the black cat's a big part of it. You've got the movie The Black Cat from, I think, 1934 with Boris Karloff and Bela Lugosi. Nothing to do at all with the short story, but it's still an awesome movie. And it's one of the few that I can think of where somebody gets skinned alive and they're absolutely deserving of it. So that's pretty intense, but also pretty great. It's another good one for Halloween, so check it out, The Black Cat. The movie, I think it's with Vincent Price, it's either Tales of Terror, I believe it is, has a segment where they combine the black cat and the premature burial together. The black cat and the cask of Amontillado together. And it works really well. Plus, Vincent Price is always amazing. Our old pal H.P. Lovecraft was a big cat fan. And they're not necessarily black cats, but he wrote the story The Cats of Ulathar, in which some wandering, I think they're like gypsies or traders or something like that, come and they end up killing some cats, and then the cats decide to take revenge and eat or devour or somehow kill these people gruesomely. So that's always a good one too, a nice favorite. Now, growing up, I had a cat. His name was Joey first, and he ran off. And then we had a cat named Tiger, who was a street-fighting cat. He had one busted-up ear, and I remember one sitting on the porch, and he came up covered in blood like he was out getting up into some shenanigans. But I really like that guy. So, yeah, cats are cool. That's all I'm trying to say here. And, yeah, pretty neat. And reminds me of Halloween, which is right around the bend, guys. So I tell you what, let's finish putting in the stars, sign it up, and we're going to take a look here at the scan, see how this guy turned out. And yeah, not the most monstrous or horrific, I know, but still, like I said, a Halloween staple, and I'm glad I got to do it. So that's it for me today, guys. All my social media stuff is up there for you to look at. And thanks again for all your likes and comments and subscribes and all that fun stuff. Keep doing it. Keep sharing the videos. Keep talking to me. I love talking to you guys. So that's it. We'll see you tomorrow for another great episode of Markers and Monsters.